My vision was not to have anybody with a suit interrupt what we're doing. That's my vision. If you have a suit on, get out of here. Because, you know, they had, you know, people who were bean counters, we used to call them, come in and tell you, oh yeah, well you shouldn't have a solo because AM radio won't. But I'm like, no. People wanted to tell you what to do, but if you hire me as an artist, let me do what I do. And tell me if you like it, you know, rather than try to. They thought they had to form the artist or reform the artist, I should say, instead of letting the artist find out who they were. And Andre was great at that because he was always behind me, backing me, what I was representing. And he would make the musicians listen to me, listen to her left hand. Listen, you know, he was so good at that. Just wonderful. At that time, women weren't acknowledged so much in the role of producer, songwriter, you know. Arranger, you know. I mean, I had a musician come in the studio one day, say to Andre, Andre's there, I'm sitting here, and he says, what does she want? Sorry, Andre, what does she want for the bridge part? He said, man, she's sitting right there. Why don't you just ask her what she wants? Because they don't see you, you know? Because it's always the man, you know? So, interesting. Well, your first album, I really didn't have any expectations because I didn't know the road. I didn't know what could or could not happen. And I didn't know there were so many other people involved in making decisions on if you even got heard. Forget about having a hit. You may not get heard if this guy doesn't run to every radio station going, hey, check out So Good, So Right. And when he did that, this one guy, Freddie Mancuso, he took my So Good, So Right record around and they thought I was white. Because I didn't sound like a black R&B, you know, diva. And so they thought, oh yeah, we'll play that. So he got them playing it on all these pop stations. And when the black stations realized that I was black, they were like, wait a minute, that's our girl, you know. So we're going to play this now. And that's how I got going. So Good, So Right. It's because they didn't know what color I was. Because I was an international kind of person. You know, I lived in Canada. I had all these different fields. I loved all kinds of music. You know, so that's what came through. Well, I always think, first of all, that when you write from your heart something, people really resonate with that. They don't even know that you were crying as you were writing it because you were so sad and so brokenhearted. They have no idea, but they feel it. And I learned a lot from that because I noticed that people really gravitated towards songs that were painful to write because they felt something in, you know, that they could, I know that feeling, you know, and that's what If Only For One Night was like. I was just like, you know, after the whole song, I was always crying. But they used to make fun of me, that my Andre and my manager, Brenda Dash, they would like, oh, here she goes. I was very emotional.